So, okay, now, so let's talk about that because we've touched on it several times now. So, when things don't go as planned, what do you do or what have you learned?
I go cry in the corner for a second.
Just for a second.
Just for a second. Just enough to say, I want to wallow and then I have to get back up and start planning again. Yeah, it's been really challenging with all of the things that could potentially go wrong. And the easy standpoint, honestly, which was funny because 6 years ago I would have said, this is a disaster. I hate planning for plan B. I would always have to come up with a rain plan for weddings. And it's one of those things that you don't want to have to work through. You don't want to have to think about it because obviously nobody wants rain on their wedding day. But then I learned that you needed to put a positive spin on it. As the tales say, it's good luck if it rains on your wedding day. And sometimes it's okay just to push through. And I've had multiple weddings that we didn't have a plan B. It was like the bride only wanted to be outside. That was the only option. It was hell or high water, and that
In
was
high
it.
water.
Yeah,
No, that's
high
kidding.
water. We had a wedding in Pensacola, Florida, and it was beautiful in the morning. And then 2 hours before the wedding, it just downpoured to the point where we weren't going to be able to have the DJ out there. And the venue kept saying, hey, we really need to make this call. I was like, no, we're going to push through. It looks like the rain is going to dissipate by the time the actual ceremony starts. And we were 15 minutes late to the ceremony, which luckily it was a destination wedding.
Right.
Everybody kind of expects it to be a little off timing, which worked to our advantage. And it ended up being beautiful. The rain went away, the clouds opened up. She has some of the coolest backdrop pictures from the clouds just rolling in, and it's amazing. And it really like turned your view around on rain. And I actually started to embrace it and love it because it created such a beautiful backdrop and something that was completely unique to the couples that actually had the rain on their wedding day. Because it didn't look like every other wedding that was shot out there, because they didn't have the perfectly blue skies. They had these moody gray clouds that would just come in and create a special arrangement, and it would blow everybody away. And then with planning for life, you just think about it the same way. Like you just, with us with our property, we had to come around and pick a new budget and do something different, and really go through and analyze what was important to us and be able to make it what it is with what we've got. And it's not always easy, but it's there.
Yeah.
You just have to look for it.